All right, Dan. I can't wait for you to hear the title of this one.
Huh?
I can't wait for you to hear the title of this one. Though I need to do a thumbnail. What should I do for my thumbnail? I need a collar. Welcome back to Ever Does Movie Ever. My name is Justin. I'm watching Ever Does Movie Ever. Today, I'm going to be talking about The Million Dollar Collar, aka The Ballad of Hector the Stowaway Dog.
It's editing Jess. Just popping in to say that my dad was in the room with me when I filmed this video and the video coming out on Friday, and I was really self-conscious for some reason, having him in the room but not in the video with me. So, I think some things slipped my mind, and I'm not as, like, loquacious? Is that the right word? I don't talk as much, I feel like, because I was just, like, a little self-conscious having him in there just, like, being in there watching me, even though he wasn't watching me, but we understand. So, sorry if I seem a little off or if I forget, you know, to say our total movie count is.
The Million Dollar Collar, aka The Ballad of Hector the Stowaway Dog, is a 1964 television release. It's about Hector, the stowaway dog, who gets entangled in many adventures. It is directed by Vincent McEveety, cinematography by Amerigo Gengarelli, editing by Robert Stafford, music by Oliver Wallace, and it's written by Lowell S. Hawley with a book by Kenneth M. Dodson. The film stars Craig Hill as Bill and Guy Stockwell as Max. This looks good for what it is, especially for the fact that I have it on DVD from someone in England, and it's also on YouTube and looks pretty decent as well. I will say there was some good movement, but otherwise, you know, it's nothing extraordinary. It was a television release in the 60s. It is in color. I know we did the Horse Masters in color and everything, so we haven't had black and white since the Moochie movies, but looks pretty good. No complaints. This is not like those other animal movies that I complain about where they follow the animal and just like stuff happens to them out in the wilderness and the regular life stuff. This is a little bit more plot driven, though circumstantial and kind of fine. It follows Hector. The first half is him kind of helping on a ship and impressing some criminals who want to end up kidnapping him because Hector's very talented. He like tames a leopard and then he, you know, helps and does all these cool tricks and earns everybody's love on the ship. And then these criminals want to kidnap him, and that's kind of the whole first half of the movie because it was the first episode. And then the whole second half of the movie is him getting found by a guy who will get him back to his owner, but that guy is a criminal and ends up wanting to stow away diamonds in Hector's collar to like smuggle them. And that's the whole second half of the movie. So they aren't like super connected other than Hector needing to get back to his owner on the ship. And it's fine. It's not great written wise. All right, my favorite part is probably Hector helping to tame the leopard, jaguar, cheetah cat, because that got everyone on the ship to really love him, including the captain who was not really loving him because the owner, the captain has a pet cat. So he was like a cat person versus a dog person, but then Hector saves everybody. So I really like that part. My least favorite part was probably just like every part of Hector being used, like the part where he was used to like be a wingman to get a woman, the part where he's used for the smuggling, the part where he's kidnapped to be used for crime or fame, whatever it might be. I don't think I'd recommend it, and I don't think I'd watch it again. It was fine. It was not, you know, amazing. I will say the two titles that I've been giving you, The Million Dollar Collar is the British title, The Ballad of Hector the Stowaway Dog is the American title, and this would be another instance of the British title being better than the American title, in my opinion. The one that comes to mind is Escape from the Dark and The Littlest Horse Thieves. Tell me which one sounds better. Just tell me which one. Specific moments, Hector being his owner's wingman, while I wasn't on board, I thought was hilarious. They mention Mallorca, which is really exciting because my friend Philippa and I love the Mallorca Files, and that's a really good show. And then the Hector helicopter, I couldn't believe they did that. That was hysterical. I couldn't deal with that. This was cute. It was quick and fun. But it wasn't, you know, the best. It was fine. It was better than the animal movies where we just, like, follow them around the wilderness for a while. Those are kind of boring. But this was better than that, at least. That's everything I have for Hector the Stowaway Dog. The Ballad of Hector the Stowaway Dog or the $1 Million Collar. My final rating is 4 diamonds out of 10. Parenthetical and Crackon are still the same. If you want to keep up with the movie I'm watching when, follow me on Instagram, Twitter, you'll find out what movie I'm watching when. I put up videos every Monday and Friday and sometimes Wednesday. Join Patreon. Got a tier starting at just $1 where you get every video a week early and a coupon code for merch. Buy merch. It's a tried and true classic. Go get it. Until next time, comment, like, subscribe. I'm not in charge of your life. You are, so you do you, and don't be the dudes that tried to kidnap Hector about it, probably, because they were pretty bad. Those movies. Perry, although that one was very much true life adventure, so, like, that one less so. So you mouth, I'm really sorry? Watch it, mister, I'm filming over here.
If they had it turned off, I'd understand.
He doesn't understand.